Hi friends, I am Karthik Ravindra Kate, BSc Final Year Student, Karnataka Science College, Dharwad. Last class, we discussed about the introduction to spectroscopy. But in this class, I am going to discuss about rotational spectroscopy or microwave spectroscopy. As I have written here, rotational spectroscopy or microwave spectroscopy. Because we are going to supply microwaves, because of those microwaves, the molecule is going to start rotating, hence this is known as rotational spectroscopy or microwave spectroscopy. Here, the microwaves have low energy as I have discussed in previous video. In this video, I am going to discuss in detail about rotational spectroscopy. And I also told that in rotational spectroscopy, we are going to determine the bond length of the molecule. See, for us, we have rigid rotator diatomic molecule, which will be discussed further. No need to worry. Let me go from first. See, this is a microwave. This is a microwave. And we have our, see, this is a molecule. Diatomic molecule. Say, this is a molecule. Say H2 or N2 or O2 or F2. Like that, it is a diatomic molecule. As a supply microwave to this molecule will not rotate because it has not got any dipole moment. Since H2, here H, single bond, H. The electronegativity of both atoms is same, so there is no dipole movement. If I consider the molecule like HCl, HBr or HF, HCN, these molecules have got dipole moment. See, H, I can write H like this. This is a H atom and Cl means it is having bigger size. I will write like this. This is Cl atom. Since Cl is having more electronegativity, so it pulls the electron density from here towards this side, that is from towards fluorine side, and having this it will get delta positive. This is a dipole moment. This is Cl atom and this is hydrogen atom. If I supply microwave to this type of this kind of molecules, these molecules start rotating. Further explaining, I should tell you, see, if both are having same mass, that is say H2, the center of gravity lies between the center. But whereas for these kind of molecules, see, the center of gravity will not be here. The center of gravity will shift towards to large atom so that to balance the mass. So the center of gravity will shift towards the larger mass atom. See, when I supply this electromagnetic radiation, the atom will start with the center, it start rotating. So I will denote it by this symbol. Whereas these kind of molecules H2 have got center of mass, but they won't rotate. So cancel it. That is, they won't rotate. Hence, these kind of molecules are called microwave inactive. Microwave inactive molecules. The molecules which have not got dipole moment, so they are not going to interact with microwaves. Such kind of molecules are called microwave inactive. And H2, N2, O2, F2 are nothing but homodinuclear molecules. That is homodiatomic molecules. These are not going to interact with microwave. Hence, it is, these are inactive. And we have other kind of molecules like CO2. This can be written as C double bond O, double bond O. This is also electronegative, this is also electronegative. And this is a electropositive atom. Since the electronegativity of both oxygen is same, it will pull the electron density towards this, and this will pull the electron density towards this. Hence, the net dipole moment will be zero. That is, the net dipole moment for CO2 is zero. These kind of molecules are called symmetric atomic molecules. Because there is a symmetry, because of this symmetry, there will be cancellation of dipole moment. Hence, the net dipole moment will be zero. If I come to benzene C6H6, this is also symmetric molecule, so it is also having dipole moment zero, hence these are also inactive. These are also microwave inactive. Whereas HCl, HF, HCN and H2O, these all are active molecules. They respond to microwave. Hence, these kind of molecules are called as microwave active. I am writing this is like a shortcut, but you should know. This is microwave active molecules. These molecules are called microwave active molecules and these have permanent or dipole movement. Some are having permanent dipole moment, but some will get dipole moment because of the interaction with this. There will be dipole movement. This is about introduction to rotational spectroscopy. Further, I am going to discuss about how we classify these microwave active molecules in terms of movement of inertia. That is, see, classification of microwave active molecules, only active, not the inactive, because inactive will not help us to deal with rotational spectroscopy. So microactive based on movement of inertia, let me say MI, movement of inertia. This is microwave active molecules based on movement of inertia. See, if I want to specify the position of a point, say, if I want to specify the position of this top with respect to axis, I can say x1, x2, x3. If x-axis, y-axis, z-axis are the corners of the wall, then I can say from that distance, x-axis it is x1 and from y-axis it is y1 and z-axis is z1. Like that, for a molecule, we have got three moment of inertia. Say IA, IB, IC along x-axis, y-axis, z-axis respectively. Say IA is the moment of inertia along x-axis, similarly IB, y-axis and IC. These are moment of inertia. Based on this, we are going to classify the microwave active molecules in terms of movement of inertia. Say this is micro rotational molecule. Rotational molecule. We classify this rotational molecule into four different types. See, these are the four different types. Linear molecule. Or linear molecule or molecule or linear rotator. This is known as linear rotator. Another class of classification is spherical top molecule. Spherical top molecule. Further, I classify this into one more category called symmetric top molecule. Further, I am going to classify a symmetric top molecule. So rotational molecule, that is which are active, are classified into four types based on movement of inertia as linear molecule or linear rotator, spherical top molecule, symmetrical top molecule and asymmetrical top molecule. For linear molecule, say HCl. HCl is a linear. This is H atom and Cl atom. If this is the axis, x-axis. If this is rotating like this, if this is a Cl molecule, consider this is a HCl, and if it is rotating like this, it is not active for rotational because there is no change in dipole moment. If it's delta plus and delta minus, it remains the same. Hence, this will not going to help us. So the moment of inertia for this is IA is equal to 0. And the other moment of inertia along y-axis, say, if this is along y-axis, if the molecule is rotating like this, delta plus delta minus, then it will be helpful for us in, so this IB is not equal to 0. But if IC is like this, if it is rotating like this, IC and IB are nothing but similar. But these are not equal to 0 and those are helpful for us in rotational spectroscopy. So if this is the rotation, it is not helpful, so IA is equal to 0. But IB like this and IC like this, this is helpful and both are equal. Such kind of molecules are known as linear rotator molecule, for which IA is equal to 0 and IB is equal to IC and both are not equal to 0. The best example is HCl. If you want one more example, we have HCN. It is written as like this, H and C single bond, 3 double bond. These are diatomic, this is triatomic. This is for linear molecule or linear rotator. Coming to spherical top molecule, I have got spherical top. For here, IA equal to IB, the moment of inertia along x-axis is equal to moment of inertia along y-axis, which is equal to moment of inertia over z-axis. But all three are not equal to 0. The best example for spherical top molecule are methane, that is CH4. Another example for spherical top molecule are SF6, sulfur hexafluoride, SF6. These are the two examples for spherical top molecule. Now coming to symmetrical top molecule, here symmetrical top molecule, we have two types of symmetrical. One is prolate and the other one is oblate. Prolate symmetrical top molecule or oblate symmetrical top molecule. The prolate symmetrical top molecule, example for this is CH3F. For this, moment of inertia IA along x-axis will be greater than IB plus IC. That is the condition, that is IA is greater than IB and IC, that is both IB and IC will be equal, but IA will be greater than IB and IC. The example for this is prolate symmetrical top molecule is CH3F. Whereas for oblate symmetrical top molecule, here the moment of inertia of IA will be less than IB equal to IC. The best example for this is BCl3. BCl3 type molecule exhibit oblate symmetrical top molecule, and for them the moment of inertia will be IA smaller than IB, which is equal to IC, that is IA smaller than IB as well as IC. Lastly, we are left with asymmetrical top molecule. Asymmetrical top molecule, asymmetry. So IA is not equal to IB, IB is not equal to IC, and all these three are not equal to 0. See, moment of inertia along x-axis is not equal to moment of inertia along y-axis and moment of inertia along z-axis. All three are different, but all three are not equal to 0. That is, they have specific value, but all the values are different from each other. The example for this kind of molecule is H2O, that is water molecule. This is about the classification of microwave active molecules on the basis of moment of inertia. These ones should be remembered, that is prolate type, oblate type, which will be asked in exams. Further, I am going to derive an expression for rigid body rotator. See, for BSc, that is for basic science students, we have got we have to derive expression for energy in terms of wave number for rigid rotator, not for unrigid, that is the bond length is fixed. Say, if a molecule start rotating, if a molecule start rotating, our common sense says that there will be expansion or compression of bond a little, that is not rigid, but we assume that the bond length is rigid, that is it is like a rod, say it is an iron rod and this is a molecule and other this which is having permanent dipole moment. When I supply radiation, it will start rotating but without changing bond length. Bond length remains fixed, hence it is known as rigid rotator. Pure rotational spectra of rigid diatomic molecule, and we have only for diatomic molecule in BSc. See, this is the expression for rigid diatomic molecules. Let me consider HCl. See, H here and Cl. And I assume that this bond is fixed. That is, the bond length is not varying. HCl molecule. Let me draw this in terms of diagram. See, H means small size. We have small molecule H. And here, let it be capital Cl. Let mass of H be M1 and mass of Cl be M2. As I told, since mass of M2 is greater than M1, the center of gravity shifts towards M2. That is here. Let C be the center of gravity C. And this is the, as I supply this, it will rotate like this along this. It will rotate like this. So we have got M1 and M2. M1 is smaller size and M2 is bigger size. This is the condition, and both are having a permanent dipole moment. And our one more assumption is the bond is rigid. Next, see, the distance between M1 and M2 form their center. I can write it R0. And the distance between this and this be R1. See, the distance between C and center of M1 be R1, and the distance between C and center of M2 be R2. The net distance will be R0. This is all my assumption. I assume that R0 is equal to R1 plus R2, and I told that this equation 1. See, R1 plus R2 is equal to R0. This is fixed. Further, see, R0. Then I know that torque acting at M1 is nothing but the torque acting at M2. Let me denote that torque acting at M1 is equal to torque acting at M2. Torque acting at M1. Torque is what torque? Torque is nothing but force into displacement. Force can be written as mass into acceleration. So I'll write mass M1 into acceleration G. What is torque? Force into displacement. This is force, and displacement is nothing but R1. See, this is R1, and torque 2 is nothing but M2 into G into R2. Whereas M1 and M2 are masses of these two. R1 and R2 is from C to this and C to this. Whereas G is nothing but gravity. Acceleration due to gravity. Since G is equal, we can cancel from both sides. Hence we get M1 R1 is equal to M2 R2. Now we know that R0 is equal to R1 plus R2. So I can write R2 is equal to R0 minus R1. Hence I will write like this only. M1 R1 is equal to M2. R2 can be written as R0 minus R1. R0 minus R1. If I multiply this, I will get M1 R1 is equal to M2 R0 minus M2 R1. If I take this towards this side, the sign changes. That is, if I take this towards left side, it will become M1 R1, and this will become plus M2 R1 is equal to M2 R0. From this I can take R1 common. Say M1 R1 plus M2 R2. If I take R1 common, it will become R1 into M1 plus M2. See, it will become If I take R1 common, it will become M1 plus M2 is equal to M2 R0. This is the expression I got. Now I will take R1 here and I will divide this by M1 plus M2. That is R1 is equal to M2 divided by M1 plus M2 times of R0. This is an expression 2, let me say afterwards. See, R1, what I did? I divided whole terms by M1 plus M2. Since M1 plus M2 cancels out, R1 is equal to M2 divided by M1 plus M2 into R0. If I substitute in terms of R2, I substituted here. If I keep R2 constant, if I substitute R1 as R0 minus R2, I will get R2 is equal to M1 divided by M1 plus M2 times R0. Both the equation I will tell as 2. See, I got R1 and I got R2. For moment of inertia, I know that moment of inertia is denoted by I, and it is given by I is equal to summation from n is equal to I. Say I is equal to 1 to n mi into ri square. This is moment of inertia. Since it is a diatomic molecule, we have only two atoms, M1 and M2. Hence, moment of inertia I is given by I is equal to 1 to 2. So, M1 R1 square plus M2 R2 square. This is moment of inertia. And I have got R1 value and R2 value. And going to substitute these two values in I, and I will get I is equal to M1 R1 square, R1 is this, I can write as M2 divided by M1 plus M2 into R0 the whole square plus M2 into R2. R2 is nothing but this, M1 divided by M1 plus M2 into R0 the whole square. That is moment of inertia. Further, I am going to simplify as I is equal to C. From here, M1 I will take common, M2 I will take common, and M1 plus M2 the whole square I will take common, and R0 square I will take common. From both the terms, see, if I take M1 common, M1 came out, I will take M2 common, M2 came out, and I will take M1 plus M2 the whole square, I will take common, that is M1 plus M2 the whole square, I will take common, and I will take R0 square common. See, if I take this common term, see, M1 came out, it will be 1, M2 square is there, so 1 M2 is left here. R0 square came out, M1 plus M2 came out. Next, going to this term, I took M2 common, came out, M1 common I took, but square is there, so plus M1 left. I took common R0 square, so R0 came, and M1 plus M2 square also came out. And I left with this. From this, it is clear that M1 plus M2, and here also M1 plus M2, I can cancel, because it is in numerator, and it is in denominator. Hence, I got I is equal to M1 M2 divided by M1 plus M2 into R0 square. This I will mark it as not the number but the star, because we need it. From this expression I am going to determine R0. What is R0? R0 is nothing but distance between M1 and M2, that is nothing but bond length. From that expression I can determine bond length. If I know M1, M2, M1 plus M2, these masses and the moment of inertia. Further, we will discuss a problem. It will be clear how we are going to determine the radius, that is bond length. Further, see, here I'm going to wrap. Please, you please rewind the video and please make the derivations clear. See, I have came with the expression I is equal to m1 into m2 divided by m1 plus m2 into r0 square. I am going to write this as here. See, I have came I is equal to m1 m2 divided by m1 plus m2 into r0 square. And I will write the same expression as I is equal to mu into r0 square. Where mu is nothing but m1 into m2 divided by m1 plus m2. But I will name it as mu is nothing but reduced mass. I will name it as reduced mass. What is reduced mass? I need to explain. Say I have taken m1 and m2. Let me give some number to m1 and m2. Let m1 be 10 unit. That is mass. Mass can be expressed in kg, gram, amu, constant unit, like that. But I will take m1 be 10 unit, any unit, and m2 be 20 unit. See, mu is what? Mu is nothing but m1 in m1 into m2, that is 10 into 20 divided by m1 plus m2, that is 10 plus 20. So I got 200 divided by 10 plus 20, 30. 6.67 unit. I got mass. Why mu is called reduced mass? I need to explain. See, I have taken m1 as 10 unit and m2 as 20 unit, but I got reduced mass as 6.67 unit. From this it is clear that the reduced mass is smaller than m1 as well as it is smaller than m2. Hence it is known as reduced mass. That is mu. Mu is given by m1 into m2 divided by m1 plus m2. I have not written here, but I have specified the name. Mu is nothing but reduced mass. You need to write it down in your notebook. Next time I am going to explain about energy. This I got the expression for moment of inertia I and in terms of reduced mass and radius. Next I need to expression for energy. Hence we are supplying electromagnetic radiation as it appears to the molecule start rotating. It will start rotating. As it starts rotating, there is a rotational energy, and we know the kinetic energy is given by half mv square. But here the molecule is rotating, it is given by half I omega square, where I is movement of inertia and omega is angular velocity. Whereas in kinetic energy, half mv square, m is the mass and v is nothing but velocity. Here velocity is replaced by angular velocity. Why angular velocity? Because it is rotating. So I will write as energy of rotation, that is ER. ER is given by, see, this is ER. Energy of rotation is given by half I omega square, where omega is angular velocity, I is moment of inertia, and IR is energy due to rotation. And we know that angular velocity is given by, see, here L is one more new term, that is new parameter. L is nothing but angular momentum. We know that momentum is denoted by P, linear momentum, mass into velocity. Whereas angular momentum is denoted by L, and it is nothing but here mass into velocity, it is I into omega, that is moment of inertia into angular velocity, whereas it was linear velocity in momentum and it is angular momentum. Moment of momentum, that is angular momentum, is given by L is equal to I omega. L is equal to I omega. I am going to substitute this value in ER, that is energy, rotational energy. See, I have got ER is equal to of
I omega square. But from this expression, I know omega is equal to L by I, and ER is given by half into I into omega, can be written as L by I the whole square, and I got ER is equal to half L square upon I, where L is angular momentum, I moment of inertia, and ER, and that is half. But in quantum mechanics, L, the value of angular momentum L is given by J into J plus 1 root of J into J plus 1 into H over 2 pi. This H over 2 pi can also be written as H cross, where H cross is nothing but reduced Planck constant. That is, its value will be less than Planck's constant. I will tell H over 2 pi, no problem, because H is 6.625 to 10 to the power minus 34 joules second. If I divide it by 2 pi, I will get H cross, that is reduced mass. And here it is square, so I will square it. L square is equal to J into J plus 1 into H square upon 4 pi square. I explained about L, I explained about H, but what is J? J is nothing but rotational quantum number. J is rotational quantum number, and J can have value J is equal to 0, 1, 2, dash, dash, dash. These are the values J can have. So I will substitute L square in ER, that is energy due to rotation is given by half L square upon I. L square is nothing but J into J plus 1 into H square upon 4 pi square, and I is I. So I will write directly as half J into half J into J plus 1 into H square upon 4 pi square divided by I, and it can also be written as ER is equal to half of 2 into 4, 8, h upon h square upon 8 pi square I into j plus 1. The unit for this, that is energy due to rotation, can be in terms of joules or in terms of electron volt. And we know that we can easily convert joules into electron volt. How? The joules, if we divide it by 4.18, we get the answer in terms of electron volt. If we have in terms of electron volt, sorry, if we want to convert joule into electron volt, we divide the joule unit divided by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. We get the answer in terms of electron volt dash electron volt. That is nothing but we can convert joule into electron volt or electron into joules. How we convert electron volt into joules? Multiplying 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19, we get the answer in terms of joules. This is the unit. I can draw graph for this. If I substitute J is equal to 0, I am going to get ER is equal to 0. If I substitute J is equal to 1, I am going to get 1 plus 1, 2, 2 L square upon 8 pi square IC. I will get a graph. That graph I am going to draw in next classes, but today my aim is to complete the derivation. This is the derivation for rotational energy, and the expression is this. The unit of this is in terms of joule or in terms of electron volt. But if the examiner asks you to express the same in terms of wave number, we know that E is equal to H nu, and this can also be written as E is equal to Hc by lambda. This can also be written as Hc into mu bar, which is discussed in our first class. We know this relation, and the relation between energy and wave number is nothing but E is equal to Hc wave number, and wave number is given by E divided by Hc. From here it is clear that if I divide by Hc, ER, if I divide it by Hc, I am going to get in terms of wave number. Hence, I will get C. If I divide by Hc, ER divided by Hc, Hh get cancelled, H square, and it becomes H, and C will be here. And I got H upon 8 pi square Ic into J plus 1. This is the energy of the diatomic rigid rotator in terms of wave number, and the unit for this will be in terms of per centimeter or per meter. Whereas this energy was in terms of joule or electron volt, like this. Here further we can write as wave number mu is equal to h upon 8 pi square I c. See, h is a Planck's constant. We know that 6 × 6.625 × 10⁻³⁴ joule second. And 8 is a constant. Pi is a constant. R is a constant because I have determined. I will not vary. Mass will not vary. Bond length is a rigidity, will also be constant. Hence, I will be constant. I is also constant. C is the thing, but velocity of light, we know that 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. Hence, this is a constant. I replace whole term by B. And I will write J × J+1. This is expression for rigid body rotator wave number in terms of wave number. Mu bar is equal to B × J × J+1, where B is a rotational constant. Why it is constant? Because all terms are constant. B value is h upon 8 pi square I c. Since all terms are constant, this is also rotational constant. And J is rotational quantum number. J is rotational quantum number. And J can have value J is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, ... For this also, I can write the graph. If J is equal to 0, mu bar is 0. If J is equal to 1, then mu bar will be 2b. If J is equal to 2, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 to the 6, 6b. Like that, I will get some values. From those values, I can draw a graph. But the unit for this will be in terms of wave number per centimeter. Whereas if I draw a graph by putting J is equal to 0 followed by 1 followed by 2, I'll get a graph, but the unit of graph will be in joules or electron volt. We can draw within these two, I can draw only one graph. If I draw only for this graph, it's enough. I'll get unit in terms of per centimeter. If anybody asks me to express per centimeter in terms of joules, what I will do? Here I divide it by Hc, I multiply by Hc. I will get the graph in terms of energy. That is, I will get the same relation back. In these two equations, if we write only one graph, it's enough for us. The graph will be drawn in our next classes. No need to worry. Now I got these two expressions. Expression for energy, rotational energy in terms of joule, and wave in terms of wave number. That is, per centimeter. I am going to rub all this and I am going to write in a corner the expression for energy and wave number. Now I will neglect energy in terms of joule, but I will take wave number in terms of per centimeter, because I know wave number can be converted into energy by multiplying Hc. Hence I will write that this is wave 1 star, that is as this I is equal to mu into r naught square, that is I moment of inertia reducing mass r naught square. Now I got expression wave number mu bar is equal to b into j plus 1, where j is a rotational quantum number having 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. And b is a constant, rotational constant, and mu is a wave number. The unit will be in terms of per centimeter, let it be double star. If I draw a graph, it will be clear for you how the energy will be varying. See, next, coming to this, let the selection rule for rotational spectra is, see, if this is J is equal to 0, the energy level, if I draw for this, mu J is equal to, say, if J is equal to 0, say mu 0 is equal to 0, if J is equal to 1, mu 1 is equal to 1 plus 1, 2, 2b. Further, if mu is equal to 2, I get 2 plus 1, 3, 3 2s are 6, 6b. If I draw a graph for this, I'll get, see, I'm drawing graph, please be concentrated. See, this is the energy. For J is equal to 0, I got this. J is equal to 0, I got mu bar equal to 0. If J is equal to 1, I got mu bar is equal to 2b. For J is equal to 2, I got 6b. Say this is 2b, means this will be 6b. J is equal to 2, I got mu bar will be 6b. If I substitute J is equal to 3, 3 plus 1, 4, 3, 4 is 12, 12b. I got around double. J is equal to 3, I got mu bar is equal to 12b. Mu bar is equal to 12b. See,
I told selectional rule are those, only those excitation will be allowed which are having allowed, which are allowed. That is, selection rule for rotational spectra is delta J is equal to plus or minus 1. That is the selection rule. Delta J will be plus or minus 1. That is, only that transition is allowed where plus or minus 1. See, J is equal to 0, J is equal to 1. The difference is 1, hence this transition is allowed. The molecule may jump from this to this. But the same molecule cannot jump from this to this because the difference will be 2. 2 minus 0 is equal to 2. This transition is not allowed. But whereas this transition is allowed, see, from J is equal to 1 to J is equal to 2, this kind of transition is allowed. See, because 2 minus 1, we get 1. Following the selection rule, I am going to draw these lines, and only these transition are allowed. From J is equal to 0 to 1 or 1 to 2 or 2 to 3, not from 0 to 2. Like that, this is not possible. The allowed transition are called allowed, and 0 to 2, 0 to 3 are not allowed. Hence those are not allowed based on selection rule. This is the graph for mu bar is equal to b into j into j plus 1. From this expression, I consider delta j is plus or minus 1, hence I can derive, say, this is mu1. Mu1 is equal to v into j plus 1. Let mu2 be v into j dash into j dash plus 1. From selection rule, I know that delta j, that is j dash minus j, should be plus or minus 1. J dash minus j should be plus or minus 1. Say, let me consider plus 1 only. Therefore, j dash is equal to j plus 1. If I substitute j dash is equal to j plus 1 by selection rule, I will get mu 2 can also be written as v into j dash is nothing but j plus 1. And j dash plus 1, j plus 1 plus 1 is nothing but j plus 2. I got this expression. Now I will subtract mu 2 and mu 1. Like that, delta mu I will write delta mu bar of rotation r is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1, that is v into j plus 1 into j plus 2 minus v into j plus 1. That is the value delta mu bar, the change in wave number, delta mu bar, the change in wave number based on transition selection rule, that is delta j is equal to plus or minus. The difference in wave number is given by, see, v into j plus 1, I can take common. V into j plus 1, I took common. I left with j plus 2 minus j. J plus 2 minus j. J, j got cancelled, and delta mu bar is nothing but b. See, j, j got cancelled, 2. 2b into j plus 1. That is nothing but delta mu bar. If I substitute, if j is equal to 0, I get delta mu bar is equal to what? Delta mu bar is nothing but 2b. If j is equal to 1, if I substitute j is equal to 1, I will get 1 plus 1, 2, 2 into 2, 4, and I will get delta mu bar is equal to 4b. If I substitute j is equal to 2, I will get 6b. If I substitute 4, 3, I will get 8b. See, 3. If I substitute 3, 3 plus 1, 4. 4 2 is 8. I got 8. 8b. Nothing but 8b. Delta mu value.
see the same graph. If I see here, see from j is equal to 0 to 1, if delta mu r is 0 to 1, transition taking from 0 to 1, then I will get 2b, the value of this. See, this is 0 and this is 2b. The difference between this is 2b. Whereas if I molecule from j1 to j2, see from 1 here mu d is equal to 4b, that is 1. 1 to 2, I will get see 6b minus 2b. This difference will be 4b. Similarly, see this is 12b and this is 6b. The difference will be 6b. I got the same 2b, 4b, 6b, 8b. Then further it will be 12b means it will be 20b. Substitute j is equal to 4. In this situation, you will get 20b. The difference will be 8b. Like that, we got this. The complete graph for this expression I have drawn, and I have not drawn the graph for this expression. This expression will be drawn in next class. Please have a glance on it. Please look it clearly. I think you might have got confused. See again. If you won't get, see again, you will get the concept. Thank you. Thank you for watching. Bye.